You walk up and there's a group of people in front of the door. They're whispering to each other. And just saying some words and everything. And they move aside for you.
Apparently I came in with the scary lady.
Yeah, I just go ahead and walk up to the door.
I don't think I gave you control.
With my catch on my shoulder. I don't know what it was. I don't have control either.
Wait, changes? Yeah,
no? I do.
Now you do?
Okay. There you go.
Alright, yeah. Vitara does the
and
same.
I just walk through the front door.
You just walk in?
Yeah, I did.
Oh.
Yeah, I guess, if the door's open.
It's unlocked. It's not locked or anything.
Oh, okay. I walk up and knock on the door. Or pound. Well, you know.
Yeah. Vitar opens the door and takes a step back. Just looks at you. Sir? Are you here for the guild? And kind of swallows a little bit.
I seek the enemies of Alpha.
He nods and says, right this way. And comes to the doorway. Yeah. By the way, you have to duck a little bit on your way through.
How tall is this guy?
He opens the door and says, sir, one more member. And greets you in.
Want to describe your character for me, Cyber?
Yeah, sure. Basically, he is, he's definitely larger than a normal man. But he only stands 7 foot. He's actually quite tiny for 7'1". He's tiny for his people. Muscles up and down. He has several tribal style tattoos on his chest, but the thing that stands out the most is he's covered head to toe in furs that basically make him almost like look like a bipedal walking bear with the headdress. And he also is carrying a stag across the back of his shoulders, and he's just kind of holding there, so it most likely he's dripping a little bit as he's walking.
Yeah. Vitar.
So, yeah. I look at your character. I'm like, wow. Welcome, friend. What is your name?
I am Maw Ripper, and I seek the enemies of Alpha.
Well, you're in good company. What's with the stag?
Probably dinner.
Yeah, it is amongst my people customary when meeting a chieftain or the leader of a hunting pack to bring them a meal to show your worthiness.
I look at Leo and I'm like, wow, if only other people would adhere to those rituals.
He catches your eyes and just puts his just doesn't say anything. Grin. He doesn't say
And
anything.
I look over at Ignis and I'm like, Ignis, please take the stag to the kitchen so that Kira may make a feast.
She nods.
Worthy of such an offering.
She nods, walks over to you, Cyber, and reaches to take the stag off you.
Yeah, I hand it down. Hand it down to her.
How tall is Ignis, would you say, Sendo?
Well, she's not terribly tall. She's elf, so she's slender, maybe 5'10".
Okay. Yeah. She takes it, she carries it with ease and walks it out.
Please, Maw Ripper, have a seat.
Is, Does there look like there's a comfortable seat for me?
We weren't really anticipating someone of his stature, so probably not.
Well, you're also, what, 6'4"? So...
Yeah.
And Maul Ripper's not...
But I have my own seat.
Yeah. Maul Ripper's also not like, large sideways by any means, is he?
Like he's big, but it's not like he's, like, you know, this massive... He's not, like, ogre-sized or anything. He basically is built... He's built like a bigger version of a human, basically.
Yeah.
So, but I go to one of the normal seats and I kind of look at it and look down and I sit down on it real slowly.
Yeah. So, yeah. How long are you going to wait to see if there's anybody else?
How long till the allotted time?
You're about 15 minutes late.
Okay. I think we've waited long enough.
Okay.
I'm looking around. I'm like, only four, huh? Well, once we get more notoriety. And then I stand up, put my arms out, and say, "Welcome, friends. For today is a glorious day where we form the guild Ragnarok."
Leon gives a little clap.
Yeah, if someone else starts clapping, I'll clap.
Yeah,
I'm like stone-faced and say, "I believe that the days of Alpha are numbered and a guild will have to take their place, such as Ragnarok. And I'm looking at Maul Ripper and Mr. Ripper. May I call you Mr. Ripper?
You may call me Maul Ripper.
Ah, my apologies. Maul Ripper, what do you seek out of a guild?
I seek the enemies of Alpha.
For what reasons?
Then I reach into my furs and I pull out the piece of the Alpha tent with their symbol on it.
Yeah, you basically
like these men. These men, these men attacked me and engaged me in a competition and then ran away. And by running away, they do me this dishonor of not being able to finish the competition. So I must find these men and end the competition to restore my honor.
So wait. Because they ran away and sullied themselves in doing so, you're dishonored?
My honor is being judged until the battle... My honor is being judged until the competition ends. For that is how the spirit seeks it.
By the way, I also want to make it clear right now. The God of War's name has been changed to Horin.
Horin?
Yeah, Horin.
I mean, I'm... Disciple of Horin.
And the God of Nature's name is still Cormi?
Yeah, Comey.
Comey. Yeah. Okay. C-O-M-I?
Yes.
Okay.
I look at you, Maul Ripper, and I'm like, "Oh, friend, I too seek the fall of Alpha. But my reasons are more for a family grudge, let's say. So I believe we will get along just fine."
This is common, and I reach in and pull out a piece of paper, well, several pieces of paper, say, "On my travels from the north, I met many people who do not like Alpha, And I hold out the pieces of paper, which basically are random people saying stuff about Alpha and then writing it down for me so I can remember it.
I look at Arcarian and say, Arcarian, what is it you seek from a guild?
To test myself, I suppose, sir.
Okay.
At this point, you'd probably notice, Sendo, that Leon keeps looking back towards Sky with just a little bit of a puzzled look.
I look over at Leon. I'm like, Leon, if you want her number, just ask.
He gives a chuckle.
Her address and, number. Right.
Yeah. He chuckles and actually puts up his finger and walks back to the back of the room. Whispers. Just has like a little conversation on the back, at the back.
I'm trying my hardest to listen in from the front. I don't get out of my seat, but I'm just like pointing my ear, trying to pick up anything.
Give me a perception check.
This is going to go well.
You don't hear a thing.
Nope. Maybe I... Damn.
Yeah.
Sir Simon, what is it you seek from a guild?
Well, I am an acolyte of Comey, and I've been chosen to be one of his warriors. And I've trained as much as I can on my own, so I'm hoping that by joining a guild, I can fulfill my purpose.
I look at you and say, yes, having someone familiar with nature, with a god of nature on their side, would be quite useful if we ever decide, I don't know, to venture out into nature. Very awkward, yeah.
Yeah, he's going to kind of think about that for a second. He's like, most places are nature, so yeah, I'm sure that would come in handy.
If you have any questions, please ask. Oh, wait, 1 second. Leon, if you're done with Sky, or if she rejected you yet, I'd like to hear what she wants from a guild.
1 second here. I just gotta make a roll. Okay. Yeah, he walks back and says, yeah, sorry. And goes back and sits down.
So, Lady Sky, what is it you seek from a guild?
What do I seek in a guild? I seek power, money. And I guess
I'm kind of looking around, waiting for the rest of it. Yeah.
She looks around and says, good people. Good people are also a good benefit to a guild.
Ah, I believe you'll fit right in here. As is our goal to take Alpha's power and make it our own. And gold. Well, with power comes gold.
She nods.
And I believe that we are good people. And I'm like looking around. Start with Arcarian, look at Simon, then just like deadpan stop at Maw Ripper.
Yeah. So,
And... Go ahead. Sorry, go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
So I'm like, my guild only has 3 rules. You do not betray information of the guild. And the guild will always take care of. Shit, I had this shit written down. I always do this, man.
Even in your campaign, you never have your notes ready.
I know. So yeah, do not betray the guild. The guild is your home. Please do not destroy it. And God, what was the last one?
By the way, as he says, do not destroy it, he starts, you all sort of think back to, as you're walking up, this place is not amazingly well kept from the outside. So just keep that in mind.
Mm-hmm. And I tell him, lastly, do not steal from the other guild members. What you take is your own. The thieves will be dealt with swiftly and harshly. Other than those 3 rules, I welcome you to the Guild Ragnarok.
Leon is just sitting there, just nodding. He doesn't really look like he's looking at you. And then, yeah. He makes eye contact with you and then puts up his hand, just... Give me a minute. And, he walks out.
Oh, I thought he was going to go try to talk to the girl again.
No. He walks out. Are you doing anything while he's out?
Yeah, I'm getting to know each person, I guess. Like trying to figure out what kind of weapons they use, that kind of stuff.
Does anybody share the information?
Oh, it's probably fairly obvious. Like, he has a pack with a scimitar and a shield strapped to it. You know, that's all his stuff in the world, so.
Yeah.
Scimitar.
Ark just has his, like, a backpack with his, bedroll and stuff, but no real weapons or anything on him.
Oh, you already told us that he used magic. Well, I guess, I would walk over to Ark. Or Carrion. I've been calling Mark Carrion since the beginning.
Yeah.
Oh, I let you know to call me Ark.
Alright. I'm like, Ark, tell me, what sort of magic do you specialize in?
What do you mean?
Well, most mages specialize in something like necromancy, fire, that kind of stuff.
Oh, well, I transformed once.
Transformed into what?
he describes like a creature to you that is like half bull, half human. Basically a minotaur.
Ah.
Without saying the word, he describes it to you.
Huh. I've yet to see anything like that in person. Interesting. And I walk up to Ma Ripper. I'm like, well, I can see your weapon's clear as day. And I kind of pat him on his shoulder. Tell me, Fred.
My weapon is... I use a weapon depending on what I'm hunting. For the things that are fast, I have my bow. For the things that are big, I have my spear.
As wise. I have this, and I kind of lift up a morning star that's hanging on my belt. It's an interesting weapon. Combines spikes with a mace.
Do you go up to Sky?
Yeah, after chatting with everyone else, I walk up to her.
She's got robes. There's no distinguishable weapons on her. And do you ask her what do you ask her?
Well, I walk up to her, I give her a slight curtsy bow, and I'm like, my lady, tell me, what's your specialty?
She laughs and she's just like, well, specialize in a lot of things. And she says, do you mean as in fighting or other things?
Well, if you were forced into a fight, how would you fight?
She moves her robes aside slightly and pulls out two short swords. She's not really showing them off to you. She's holding them both like sideways beside her, just like showing mm-hmm. you that she has two short swords. And she slides them back into their sheath. She then reaches to her sides and pulls out two daggers, shows them to you, puts them back in, and then she bends down, reaches to her leg, pulls up another dagger, shows it to you, and then puts it back. She says,
My guy has this look of impressive, or being impressed, like, wow.
She giggles a bit, and says, I can handle myself in a fight.
I'm glad to hear that.
Yeah, she laughs. Do you ask her any other questions?
Basically just small talk, trying to get to know her, and maybe a little bit of flirting here and there.
She doesn't really say too much, and you probably get like 30 seconds of talking to her, and then the door opens and Vitar comes in, and Leon behind him, and Vitar says, there's some unwanted people, men in the front, at the front door, sir.
What kind of unwanted people, Vitar?
From what Leon tells me, they are men of Alpha, sir.
I look over, like, immediately over to Ma.
Mm-hmm. Alpha. I stand up. And I start to walk out.
I follow him.
Yeah. Yep, same thing.
Yeah. Are we going somewhere? And
I walk up to Vitar and put my hand on his shoulder and I'm like, see to Kira for a moment.
Yes, Ark, we're going to the front door to watch Ma Ripper kill these guys from Alpha.
Actually, as you walk by, you see Akira sweeping up some of the blood that got dripped on the floor.
I'm like, Kira, how goes the roast?
It's going, sir. It's over the fire at the moment, as we speak.
Excellent. Now I'm going to go see something entertaining.
Leon says as you guys are walking out that they're not actually Alpha, but they're one of their allying guilds.
So, if Ma Ripper lets me, I'll walk in front of him.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Oh, apparently you go behind them. He's trying to turn them all around.
I just teleport behind him. Like, oh, small group of rabble.
Rabble? Who are you calling rabble?
I look around and, like, well, the weeds in front of me that need to be cut down.
This guy over here starts looking around at the grass.
Probably quite a bit of weeds.
Yeah, I was going to say. It's not well kept.
I thought we were coming out to confront Alpha.
Yeah. Yeah, you see the
it's a metaphor, Ball Ripper.
You see they adorn a stylized K. There's no Alpha symbol.
Are they all in armor?
The two on the sides are in chainmail.
What about the other four?
They're just in clothes, like nothing, no real proper armor. Right?
Oh,
yeah.
I seem to remember that I forgot my armor inside.
Yeah. The one on your left looks over to you and says, Are you the one that's starting the guild named Ragnarok?
Yes, that would be me.
And are these...
My name is Drake Rock.
Trying to think, he's thinking to himself, and the one on the other side says, "Are these your guild members?"
Well, we haven't drank any cups of loyalty yet, so it's up to them.
He also says, "Except for the two behind you, there, they're already in guilds."
I look behind me.
And there's,
at Ma Ripper and Simon. Like
he's looking towards these two. To Leon and Sky.
Well, I still look at Ma Ripper and Simon.
I don't know what he's talking about.
Oh, I forgot. Oh, yeah, no. These two would be outside. Keep forgetting that this is actually inside.
Okay, no, if they were outside, yeah. I'd look at them.
No, yeah.
Yes, Leon is in a guild. And I look over to Sky, I'm like, well, that explains a bit.
She starts laughing. And you then see her hand over a stone to Leon. And he recognizes the stone to be the telestone.
Yeah. I'm like... I just shake my head at him and like, well,
he
did your
he smiles a bit
puppet masters send you to disrupt this guild meeting?
Nobody sent us. We came to stop this creation.
You didn't do a very good job, did you?
As you say that, a smile comes up on my face.
This guy right here starts laughing. He says, what do you mean? Turned down about 3 times the amount that actually made it in, it seems.
Oh, seems you failed to let in the good ones.
A couple of them start laughing, and then... And then they all make eyes with Maw Ripper and stop laughing.
Well, if you're not with Alpha directly, then get off my property.
This guy over here once again pipes up and says, "No way. We're staying here and we're stopping you where you stand."
I let out a sigh. And I look at him. Character sheet was popped out. And I'm just going to cast Guiding Bolt on him.
Okay. All right.
Dang. And I speak up and say, "You fools don't understand. This is the Guild Hall, Ragnarok. Be gone, or share his fate."
He drops and roll initiative. So how do you add to...
I wasn't expecting it to do that much damage, damn.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, I have to select my token first.
So I have two left. Cool. Oh man, I gotta add an initiative button. Forgot to do that, the macro.
There is one on the first.
Yeah, there's one on the sheet.
Yeah, but I'm used to having it down by the names.
Alright, everybody got their initiative in?
Yep.
Okay. Alright, Maw Ripper, you're first.
Okay. What's the two on the sides, are they the ones wearing the armor and then the rest are normal, or...?
Yeah, this one's already fallen over.
Okay.
Yeah, he took a bolt of magical force directly to the face.
Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and charge this one. And I'm gonna go ahead and hit him with my spear.
Alright.
And I fucking fumbled. Figures. First roll and I fumble. Then I crit the second.
So how does fumbles work in your game?
We're doing it the same as yours. You mean save
versus death?
Yeah, save versus death.
Okay. Save versus death. Seven, so percentile, right?
Yep. Oh. I guess I need to pull up the fumble chart.
Oh, God.
Oh, no.
So what was... What was this weapon?
How do you do a save versus death?
Heavy spear. Four spear.
You might actually die from yourself in the first fight.
Yeah, you critical hit self, and I'll just take the crit damage from the attack. So, you take 20 damage.
I told folks I was gonna die.
You just did 20 damage.
Yeah, I probably impaled myself. Probably ran forward and
tripped.
Wouldn't want to swing it. Yeah.
Yeah, you tripped and fell and onto your spear and it went into your chest.
How much health do you have?
13.
Yeah.
Oh, so you're still alive. You're just dead.
Yeah. Imagine if it actually. Wow. That is actually possible.
Gosh, if I did that, I'd be dead. Oh, I would have killed myself.
So everybody sees this big giant guy start running forward and just trip on it. He hits the bottom step and just, I guess, thinks there's one more step and just takes a fumble forward and drops his weapon on the ground and it just bounces in an odd way and goes into his stomach and he rolls over bleeding.
Oh, I'm like, I just look towards him. I'm like, well, that was unexpected.
So this guy starts laughing just maniacally. And then, lost my sheet here. He pulls out a dagger and starts walking up. Comes right up to you, Drake, and takes a swing. Fifteen, you're not wearing your armor. Does that hit?
I know. Yeah.
You take 4 damage.
Okay, that hurt.
Alright. This guy here comes up beside him and attacks you as well. Missing.
Yeah.
Arcarian?
God.
Well, I was going to do something funny, but I guess I should really attack them. Since we're not looking so well.
Yeah, Maw Ripper kind of has that all handled, so.
My guy was kind of expecting them all to focus on Maw Ripper. So I'm just like, shit.
Ark is going to kind of snap his fingers, and he is using... do I not have it on here? Tides of Chaos, I think it's called.
Thank you.
Okay, what does that do?
Which will give him advantage.
Is it targeted or on all?
No,
attacks?
It's on self.
Yeah. Okay.
It's a secondary action or whatever, and then he's gonna attack as well.
Oh, okay. So you just get it this turn.
Yeah.
All right.
Mm-hmm. It's the class thing that I
okay.
get level one.
Yeah, I didn't actually look at it, so I guess that's all
and
my...
And then after... Okay, well, for this turn, I do that. I'm going to do a chromatic orb at the white-haired dude.
Okay.
And make it frost damage.
All right.
So... Where is... Sorry.
No, it's alright. First encounter. I'd expect it to be a little bit slow.
Oh, not very good.
So
up
oh,
for
yeah.
15.
Yeah. He's down.
Oh, hey!
Yeah, they're not wearing any armor. So...
Okay. And then just so you know, because I use Tides of Chaos, you can make me do that other thing at any time.
Okay.
Oh yeah, roll on the wild table chart.
Yeah. Do you want me to roll for fail or no?
Not right now.
Okay.
So Blondie comes up, seeing that you attacked the guy next to him. He walks
oh,
up
shit.
To here, and he attacks you. 14?
That hits.
He's got a club, by the way. So he smacks you in the face for 2.
Okay. And oh, shit.
He's dead.
-2.
Drake? Drake? Sendo?
Oh, sorry, I put up my mic.
There you go.
So I am going to attack with my Morning Star.
Alright. Which one are you attacking?
And I'm going to be using my bonus attack as well.
What's your bonus attack?
It lets me do a second attack as a bonus action.
Oh. Where do you get that from?
From being a war priest.
Okay. All right. Roll.
So, first attack.
Miss. Oof. And miss.
Wow.
Okay.
I'm resetting my seed.
Yeah. I think a lot of people are going to need to. All right. This guy walks by chuckling. And actually, he's going to stand back, basically standing over top of Ma Ripper's body and looking up towards Leon and Sky. And they just put their hands up. Simon?
Let's see. What would a 20 foot square would be like that?
10 feet away from, well,
from the center point, if I pick that as a center point.
Yeah, 10 feet.
Does
from
it
the
say
point.
That it's a 10 foot radius or 20.
It says 20 foot square.
Square. So yeah, okay, it'd be yeah. Something like that.
Should I attack or should I entangle them? Try to entangle them.
It's up to you.
I think I'm going to go for the entangle.
Alright.
So they have to make a DC 13 strength check to not be restrained.
And if they're restrained, they get a disadvantage on attacks.
Cast a spell must succeed a strength saving throw or be restricted by the end. Okay.
So it would be these three, not unfortunately not the one that attacked Ark.
Yeah. So this is a guy beside Maw Ripper. Fail. And then the other two, the redhead succeeds and the guy on the left here fails. So, creature restraining the plants can. Okay.
Yeah, and you'll see him whisper and then make a upward motion, and all of a sudden vines come out and start grabbing at every at them.
All right. Safe versus death, Maw Ripper.
Yep.
Fail.
Nope. That's one. Yeah.
All right.
Next.
Yeah. So redhead is fine. He's gonna take another swing at you, Sendo. 16.
Hit.
Deals 2 damage. This guy's gonna make a strength check to get out. He gets out. And he's gonna step.
So if somebody is restrained, do they get disadvantage on attack rolls? How does restrain work?
Now. That's what I was trying to open up. Restrained creatures, speed becomes 0. And it can't benefit from any bonus to its speed. Attack rolls against the creature have disadvantage, so I guess attack rolls against any creature? I don't know. The creature has disadvantage on dexterity throws. So yeah. He spends his turn basically cutting at the weeds and frees himself out of it. And Arcarian?
So I kind of reach out to this guy who's next to me and try and grab him by the shoulders, and I'm going to cast Shocking Grasp.
Okay. For 1 damage. Alright.
13 for 1?
Yep, you deal 1 damage to him.
And then I move away.
He gets an attack of off if you do.
No, he's If he gets hit, he can't take reaction until the start of his next turn.
Yeah, good point.
That's useful.
Good combo.
That one damage helped.
Yeah. So he walks back up to you.
Yeah.
And attacks 18.
Yeah, that hits.
For 2 damage. Drake.
All right.
You hear Leon say, "Do you need my help?"
I'm gonna cast a Cure Wounds on myself and say, "If you want, just another bar brawl."
He starts laughing.
So I heal myself for 5.
Alright.
I look back at Ark. Sorry. I only got 1.
Alright. This guy says that to Leo and says, "If you want to join in, I'm ready for you." And he just takes his stance in ready.
Hoping that he'll fall on his sword like Maw Ripper.
Pretty much. Simon?
Okay. I'm going to step up and this guy. And then I can... Okay, so I have a Savage Attacker, so I can... Do I just need to roll twice? I know...
What?
I can take the best damage roll of 2 rolls. I don't think it's going to get better than that. It's not going to get better than
no,
that.
It's not going to get any better. Might as well leave that. So,
yeah.
Yeah, you take an attack at him, and he goes down. All right. Leon takes a couple, takes a step forward and looks over and sees Simon take out that guy with just 1 swing. And he just steps back again. Maw Ripper, save versus death. Pass.
Yep. There you go.
Redhead's gonna attack you again, Drake. 12. Does that hit? 2 dex.
No, 12.
Yeah, 12 hits.
With my shield. Does not.
Oh, you have your shield. Okay. Tie goes to
yeah, my defender. Shield was on my back. And yeah. My Morningstar was on my side.
Forgot you had your shield. Alright, that guy's down. Arcarian?
The shield gives me 13, so.
Okay. Keep that in mind.
I do the same thing and do Shocking Grasp on him again.
Alright.
19 for 3.
And
he's
down.
Oh. Yeah. Then I run away from him.
Yeah.
He tries to push him off of him, turns to run, and then realizes he falls down.
Wait, yeah.
Drake?
All right, I'm going to be doing 2 attacks again.
All right.
I have to save 1 heal for... What's his name?
Yeah.
Don't think 10 hits, does it?
No. Tie.
All right, my bonus attack.
15 for 9. And he is down.
I only have 1 more bonus. Or no, I'm out of bonus attacks.
Yeah. Alright. Discard. Discard size.
Yeah, I kind of look at him. I'm like...
He should still be restrained, too.
You're still up for this?
Oh, yeah. Actually, yeah. Yeah, he's basically been standing there. He takes his action to try to get out. He starts actually hacking at the weeds now, and gets out, and he says,
"Gets out.
Come on then," and starts smacking his spear against his chest.
I look over to Simon and be like, "God, all of Alpha's slaves are retarded."
Simon?
And I look at Simon, and if you'll let me, I'll kind of like head nudge to a javelin that's on my back. Like, "Hey, Simon, bet you can't hit him from here."
Sure. I'll grab one of the javelins and throw it. I don't know what damage and everything it is.
Just roll a ranged, D6. Ranged attack, and then if it hits, D6. Ranged with strength. Ranged strength attack. So just roll a melee attack. Basically just hit attack on a blank slot. Oh, second. You're using the other thing. Never mind.
There you go. That should work. Oops.
Yeah. You miss.
Yeah.
And he laughs. Maw Ripper. Save versus death. Actually.
Yeah,
save versus death. Pass.
So that's two successes, one fail.
Yep.
If you get a one, you still die.
Yeah, I know. Arcarian?
He is going to throw a firebolt at him.
Okay.
17 for one.
You deal one damage. Drake?
Does he look like he's ready to strike if I move up close to him?
Yes. No, he's not, because he used his action to get himself out of the weeds.
So I'm going to move here and... And yeah, I'll swing. Oh, damn it, I just closed my...
Never close your character sheet. You hit him for 7.
Mm-hmm.
He's looking a little... You got him in the chest, but he's still looking okay.
I'm like, it's just surrender. I mean, you're gonna die, but at least you won't die from fire.
He swings his he twirls his sword and he says, "Never, scum," and
just let out a sigh, like,
yep. 16.
Oh, he hits.
Yep.
Wonder if that would work.
For one.
Maybe it's a glancing blow because of my shield.
Yeah. Yeah. Simon?
I'm gonna bound down the steps and slash with my scimitar. See if this works. Oh, it does show the 2 damage. So the first one.
So why does it? Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. That's cool. All right. You take him out. He falls.
I immediately walk over to Maw Ripper. If combat's over, go to heal him.
Yep, go ahead.
And actually, do I have that prepared? Yes, I do. I'll do that to you.
Simon also heals? Okay. So you get healed for 12. So you go up to 12.
Okay.
After that, I look around for my javelin.
It's sitting behind there.
Okay.
There's a couple weeds around it, but you're kind of used to searching through the weeds for javelins.
Yeah. I'm like, at least it's not on the roof.
Yeah. And you actually hear some whispers coming from these two.
Mm-hmm.
And, they're just conversing. And,
So what are we going to do with all these, sir? And I'll motion around to the dead bodies.
I pull out the flyer and I'm like, oh, it says here the Alpha pays for garbage, so.
Leon's just like, that's, might not be such a good idea. Yeah. That's what he says.
I'll sigh like, all right, fine. Collect valuables then. Maw Ripper, if you want any trophies, go ahead.
I pull my spear out of my chest as my wounds are closing.
Yeah.
My failure just dictates that I do not take a trophy from this kill.
I nod. Does this guy have anything important on him? Their leader.
Here. Well, 1 second. Let's see here. Forgot to bring up my thing. Throughout all the guys, you get about 11 gold.
All right, I hand it out evenly, unless somebody complains.
No.
Well, like I said, I don't take anything.
I give you a pat on your back. I'm like, sorry, I should have warned you about that loose step on the bottom.
It is not the first time I have been impaled upon my own spear.
Well, friend, hopefully it's the last.
One can hope.
And I flick a gold over to Leon.
He catches it and pockets it.
He's going to go, so how much is that a piece?
We got 11 gold. I gave one to Leon and split the rest up evenly. So
keeping one extra for yourself.
Three
each with one extra.
Okay.
Yeah. Everyone gets three. I get one.
Gira comes out to the door and says, oh, the roast is ready. She's looking around outside.
As we're
I look at her and like
shuffling through dead guys' pockets.
I yell in. I'm like, Vatar.
One second here. Okay. Vatar makes his way up.
I tell him. Call the crypt keeper. Have some new additions for his crypt.
He knows.
On the bill of Alpha, of course.
Yes, sir. And he walks in to get stuff prepared to head out.
And Simon's gonna kind of line all the bodies up and say a prayer over all of them.
Okay.
Very noble.
Prepared to Comey.
All right. So you line them and make a prayer then?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And I wait patiently until you're done.
If you ask for help moving them, I'll help you. Otherwise, I'll just wait.
No, he would move him himself. He wouldn't ask somebody else to do it.
Yeah, it's not very difficult.
So, yeah.
So do you do anything else out here?
Oh. When that's all done, I clap my hands, look over to Lady Sky, I'm like, well, we have a feast. Maybe you'll be so inclined to tell us what guild you're actually from.
And we'll be going to break. We're going to take a quick 10-minute break here. Thank you guys for watching. Yeah, we will be back.